Hi, this is Joel Perlmutter, Director of the APDA Advanced Research Center at Washington University. I want to take this opportunity to congratulate Debbie Geyer and the rest of the Greater St. Louis Chapter of the APDA for the honor of the Esposito Award. This is a tremendous honor and reflects all of the hard work that you have done in the chapter supporting the mission of the APDA and our local community, people and families affected by Parkinson's disease. You also have been a tremendous help to the movement disorders group and the Parkinson's research efforts at Washington University. Over the last 30 years, you've contributed over $4 million to support our efforts. These funds have been used to collect preliminary data that have translated into multiple NIH grants. Along the way, this has not only helped to identify new problems and new solutions for Parkinson's disease, but also has helped the training of new clinician scientists. There are a large number that have been affected by this. The support has covered areas such as efforts by Brad Reset and his group, including Susan Criswell and Allison Willis, and they've done research on environmental exposures related to Parkinsonism. They've done research on epidemiology of Parkinson's, health disparities, and how treatment for Parkinson's differs in ethnic groups. This has been incredibly important for helping to understand the causes of Parkinsonism and identify potential new treatments. It also has been important to understand how our healthcare system has disparities across various ethnic groups so that we can then address this important problem. In addition, research has covered work that I've done with my group that has included efforts to look at longitudinal studies in people with Parkinson's to identify biomarkers and new targets in the brain for treatment of Parkinson's disease, particularly focusing on cognitive problems. This research has produced multiple new findings, identifying new targets in the brain, and has also helped launch the careers of multiple people, including Dr. Megan Campbell, Dr. Paul Kotzbauer, and others who have been involved with research, and also including, I should say, Jay Mighty, a new junior assistant professor in our group. Over the years, you have also helped with identifying new biomarkers to identify progression of disease. This has helped with people such as Scott Norris and Morvard Karimi, who we take a moment to remember, as well as Dr. Jonathan Mink. All of these people have been involved in our radiochemistry group have been supported by your efforts, including Will Tu, Stephen Moreline, Jinbin Zhu, all of these people, again, also working on identifying new radiopharmaceuticals, new ways of measuring pathways in the brain that are pertinent for Parkinson's disease. Dr. Gammon Earhart, which you have also supported, has done seminal work in dance and exercise therapy rehabilitation of people with Parkinson's, particularly focusing on gait. Aaron Foster in occupational therapy is looking at prospective memory. Again, with your support, all of these people, from what you've done, the Greater St. Louis Chapter, Debbie, you've made a huge difference. You've kept us here. You've kept our research going forward. You've helped us in great ways, financially, working together as a team, helping to take care of patients, and helping encourage your community to participate in our research. That also is important. All of these things help this team move forward. We thank you very much. It's a wonderful honor to have the Esposito Award. Congratulations.